गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम टू दिस क्लास ऑफ साइंस, ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ साइंस. आई एम वेलकमिंग यू, आई एम मिसेस खान SM, वेलकमिंग यू फॉर ऑनलाइन क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर साइंस. फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ साइंस इज लिविंग वर्ल्ड एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ माइक्रोब्स. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ दिस लेसन और बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ दिस लेसन, सम क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन हियर अंडर द टाइटल कैन यू रिकॉल. दैट मीन्स दिस इंफॉर्मेशन यू लर्न इन यूअर प्रीवियस क्लास. I know you all know these answers, but I am repeating it. First question is that what is the hierarchy of classification of living organism? What is the hierarchy of living classification of living organism? You all know that first one is kingdom, another is phylum, third one class, fourth order, fifth family, sixth genus, and seventh species. This is the hierarchy of living organisms. Second question is that who invented binomial system of nomenclature? Carl Linnaeus invented this binomial classification system. Third question is that which levels of hierarchy are considered while writing the names in binomial nomenclature? While writing the name of or scientific name or binomial nomenclature, genus and species, these two levels are considered. When we write any name in binomial system, it is of the two part. First part is of the genus and second part is the species. Students, now we will start our lesson. In this lesson, we are going to see, first of all, biodiversity and need of classification. Then what is the biodiversity? Biodiversity means all the living organisms which are present on the earth or on that particular area is called as a biodiversity of that particular area. If we consider biodiversity of a particular area, then all the living organism, then it will be organisms, small organisms, microorganisms, it will be plants, it will be animals, all the types of living things will be included in the biodiversity. Biodiversity is very vast, and if we want to study them, we have to classify them. We have to classify them, and after classification, we can study them very easily. Students, previous year you learned that all the living organisms on the earth have adapted according to their geographic regions, food ingestion, defense, etc. While adapting, many differences are observed in the organism of same species also. According to 2011 census, around 87 million species of living organisms are found on the earth, including land and sea. To study such a vast number, it was essential to divide them into groups. So groups and subgroups were created considering the similarities and differences among the living organisms. This process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups is called biological classification. Students, here history of classification is given in your lesson. In history, Carl Linnaeus in 1735 divided living world into two kingdoms. He divided all the living things, all the living world into two kingdoms, Vegetabilia and Animalia. That means vegetables, that means plants and animals. Haeckel in 1866 considered three kingdoms, Protista, plants and animals. Haeckel added one more, that is Protista. In 1925, Chetan created two groups, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In 1938, Copeland divided living organisms into four kingdoms, Monera, Protista, plants and animals. In 1920 to 1980, Robert Harding Whittaker was an American ecologist. In 1969, he divided living organisms into five groups. See, Copeland divided living organisms into four kingdoms. Now he divided into five groups. For this classification, Whittaker considered some criteria. Then what were the criteria? See, picture on the screen, it is a Whittaker's classification. He considered first criteria, that is complexity of cell structure. That means the cell structure. You all know all living organisms are made up of cells. They may be unicellular, they may be multicellular, but all are present, are all are made by cells. But these cells, which type of these cells are? Prokaryotic and eukaryotic. You all know that prokaryotic, that means in that nucleus is not surrounded by any layer. Nuclear layer is not there around the nucleus. And in eukaryotic, nuclear layer is present around the nucleus and one layer is present in around the another organelles also. This was the first criteria. Another criteria was complexity of organism, that is unicellular and multicellular. Some organisms are unicellular, that means they are made up of only one cell, and some are made of more than one cell, that means multiple of cells are there, many cells are there, more than one cells are there in the body. Third type was mode of nutrition, that means plants autotrophic, that is photosynthetic. Plants, they can prepare their food by themselves. As they have chlorophyll in them, they can prepare their food by themselves, and so they do photosynthesis, and by the process of photosynthesis they make their food, and so they are called as autotrophic. Auto means self. They are self-dependent for their food. Another is fungi. Saprophytic. Saprophytic means they absorb their food material from dead substances or dead organisms. We all also know that the fungus do not have chlorophyll in them. That means it cannot produce the food, and so it is depend on the other organic material, other organic substances for the food, and so it is called as a saprophytic. Third group is heterotrophic and ingestive. Heterotrophic means these groups, animals come under this group. That means they also cannot produce their food. They are depend on the others for their food. They are depend on plants. They are depend on animals for their food. These are called as a heterotrophic. These are the three type of the nutrition, and these are the three levels. These, on this basis also he classified plants and animals. Fourth criteria is the lifestyle. Lifestyles means plants, it is a producers. As they produce their food, they are producer. Animals, consumers. As animal cannot produce their food, they only consume their food from plants and animals. And fungi, fungus or fungi, they can decompose organic substances for their food. So they are called as a decomposer. That means producer, consumers and decomposers. These are the three lifestyles. And fifth criteria is phylogenetic relationship. That means prokaryotic to eukaryotic, unicellular to multicellular. These are the basis of the classification of Whitaker's classification.